Amen. We're going to read it out loud. We're going to read it out loud. Isaiah chapter 37. Amen. And another one. We're going to need that. Spiritual superfood. True living bread and water. Good. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to read your word so it may heal those who are going through infirmity and pain. Thank you for the opportunity to pray over them, that you watch over them, comfort them, protect them, entertain them with your truth, your purpose. May our free will be drawn to your will, aligned, so we may abide by the true living bread and water whereby you eat, that every word read will heal, strengthen, inspire, motivate for the listener and the viewer to grow, develop a closer, deeper relationship with you, Lord Jesus, and that they will never feel alone or left out, but receive and laugh, even if it's just for a few moments, that few moments will become an everlasting covenant, a relationship built on the reading of your word and growing close to it, publicly as well as privately. And be here listening according to God's wishes and glory. And thank you, Lord, for answering this prayer into your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God. Amen again. Isaiah chapter 37. Hezekiah asked Isaiah to pray. Verse 1. And it came to pass, when King Hezekiah heard it, that he went his clothes, and covered himself with sackcloth, and went into the house of the Lord, Verse 2. And he sent Eliakim, who was over the household, and Shebna the scribe, and the elders of the priests covered with sackcloth, unto Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos, Verse 3. And they said unto him, that said, Hezekiah, this day is the day of trouble, and of rebuke, and of blasphemy, for the children are come to the birth, and there is not strength to bring forth, Verse 4, it may be the Lord thy God will hear the words of Rabshakeh, whom the king of Assyria, his master, hath sent to reproach the living God, and will reprove the word which the Lord God hath heard, wherefore lift up thy prayer for the remnant that is left, Judah delivered from Sennacherib, Verse 5. So the servants of King Hezekiah came to Isaiah, Verse 6. And Isaiah said unto them, thus shall ye say unto your master, thus saith the Lord, be not afraid of the word that thou hast heard, wherewith the servant of the king of Assyria have blasphemed, Verse 7, behold, I will send a blast upon him, and he shall hear a rumor, and return to his own land, and I will cause him to fall by the sword of his own land, Verse 8. So Rabshakeh returned, and found the king of Assyria warring against Libna, for he had heard that he was departed from Lachish, period. Verse 9. And he heard say concerning Tirhaka, king of Ethiopia, coming. He is come forth to make war with thee, period. And when he heard it coming, he sent messengers to Hezekiah, saying, coming, verse 10, that shall ye speak to Hezekiah, king of Judah, coming, saying, coming, let not thy God, coming, in whom thou trusted, coming, deceive thee, coming, saying, coming, Jerusalem shall not be given into the hand of the king of Assyria. Period. Verse 11. Behold, come, thou hast heard what he, the king of Assyria, have done to our land by destroying them utterly. Semicolon. And shalt thou be delivered? Question mark. Verse 12. Have the gods of the nation delivered them which my fathers have destroyed? Come, as Gozan, come, and Haran, come, and Rezap, come, and children of Eden, and the children of Eden which were in Telasta. Question 1. Verse 13. Where is the king of Hamat, come, and the king of Arphad, come, and the king of the city of Sevan, come, Hena, come, and Ivor? Question 1. Verse 14. And Hezekiah received the letter from the hand of the messenger, and read it. Curling. And Hezekiah went up into the house of the Lord, come, and spread it before the Lord. Period. Verse 15. And Hezekiah prayed unto the Lord, come, son, come, verse 16. O Lord of hosts, come, God of Israel, come, that dwelleth between the cherubim, come, thou art the God, come, even thou alone, come, of all the kingdoms of the earth, come, thou hast made heaven and earth, period. Verse 17. Incline thine ear, come, O Lord, come, and hear, semicolon. Open thine ear, come, O Lord, come, and see, come, and hear all the words of Sennacherib, come, which have sent to reproach the living God, period. Verse 18. Of a truth, come, Lord, come, the kings of Assyria have laid waste all the nation, come, and their country, come, verse 19, and have cast their God into the fire, come, for they were no gods, come, but the work of men's hands, come, wood and stone, come, therefore they have destroyed them, period. Verse 20, now therefore, come, O Lord our God, come, save us from his hand, come, that all the kingdoms of the earth may know that thou art the Lord, come, even thou only, period. Verse 21. Then Isaiah, the son of Amos, sent unto Hezekiah, come, saying, come, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, come, whereas thou hast prayed to me against Sennacherib, the king of Assyria, colon, verse 22. This is the word which the Lord hath spoken concerning him, semicolon. The virgin, comma, the daughter of Zion, comma, hath despised thee, comma, and laughed thee to scorn, semicolon. The daughter of Jerusalem hath shaken her head at thee, period. Verse 23. Whom hast thou reproached and blasphemed? Question mark. And against whom hast thou exalted thy voice, comma, and lifted up thine eyes on high? Question mark. Even against the Holy One of Israel, period. Verse 24. By thy servant hast thou reproached the Lord, comma, and has said, comma, by the multitude of my chariot, am I come up to the height of the mountain, comma, to the size of Lebanon, colon, semicolon, and I will cut down the tall cedars thereat, comma, and the choice fir trees thereat, colon, and I will enter into the height of his border, comma, in the forest of his climate, period, verse 25. I have dead, comma, and drunk water, semicolon. And with the sole of my feet have I dried up all the rivers of the besieged places, period, verse 26. Hast thou not heard long ago how I have done it, semicolon, and of an ancient time, comma, that I have formed it, question mark. Now have I brought it to pass, comma, that thou shouldest be to lay waste the fenced city into ruinous heap, period, verse 27. Therefore their inhabitants were of small power, comma, they were dismayed and confounded, colon, they were as the grass of the field, comma, and as the green earth, comma, as the grass on the housetop, comma, and as corn blasted before it be grown up, period, verse 28. But I know thy abode, comma, and thy going out, comma, and thy coming in, comma, and thy rage against me, period, verse 29. Because thy rage against me, comma, and thy tumor, comma, is come up into my ears, comma. Therefore will I put my hook in thy nose, comma, and my bridle in thy lip, comma, and I will turn thee back by the way by which thou camest, period, verse 30. And this shall be a sign unto thee, comma, ye shall eat this year such as growth of itself, semicolon, in the second year that which springeth of the same, colon, and in the third year sow ye, comma, and reap, comma, and plant vineyard, comma, and eat the fruit thereof, period, verse 31. And the remnant that is escaped of the house of Judah shall again take root downward, comma, and bear fruit upward, colon, verse 32. For out of Jerusalem shall go forth a remnant, comma, and they that escape out of Mount Zion, colon, the zeal of the Lord of hosts shall do this, period. Verse 33. Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the king of Assyria, comma, he shall not come into this city, comma, nor shoot an arrow there, comma, nor come before it with shield, comma, nor cast a bank against it, period. Verse 34, by the way that he came, period. By the way that he came, comma, by the same shall he return, comma, and shall not come into the city, comma, says the Lord, period. Verse 35, for I will defend the city to save it for mine own sake, comma, and for my servant David's sake, period. Verse 36. Then the angel of the Lord went forth, comma, and smote in the camp of the Assyrians 144 and 5,000, colon. And when they arose early in the morning, comma, behold, comma, they were all dead corpses, period. Verse 37. So Sennacherib, king of Assyria, departed, comma, and went and returned, comma, and dwelt at Nineveh, period. Verse 38. And it came to pass, comma, as he was worshiping in the house of Nisroch, his god, comma, the Adrammelech and Sherezer, his sons smote him with the sword, semicolon, and they escaped into the land of Armenia, colon, and Esarhaddon, his son, reigned in his state. Period. Wow, that's the end of Isaiah chapter 37. Clutch! And then love y'all. Thank you for reading out loud with me. Welcome. Be healed. Get that food in there. It's good for it. Amen. It's good. Trust me. Oh, yeah. You gonna need that equipment for your next start and so forth. Yeah. Next step. Next breath. Next move. In Jesus Christ's name. Isaiah chapter 37. That's wow, man. Go back and study if you want, man. Get it in there, you feel me? God loves you in Jesus' name. I'm gonna get to y'all later on. Be good. Get along. No fight. Peace out. In Jesus' name. Good. And later.